How are you?
Good.
Good?
Yeah.
Ready to rock and roll?
Olivia is our very severe asthma patient.
She's been on steroids for a long time, taking oral steroids every day for years and years. She's gone to dozens of doctors. She's taken everything under the sun. So we decided that we will try this novel treatment for her, which has been recently shown to help patients with severe diseases like her. So we enrolled her in our clinical trial of bronchial thermoplasty.
We almost lost her not too long ago. I mean, they were straddling her and everything, telling her, don't stay with us, don't you go to sleep, you know, and patting her face and took her off in the ambulance. And that was one of the probably hardest things that I had to deal with among all the others. But I'm so thankful for this.
Four months of doing exhaustive testing. Of course, the reason to do all these tests is to come up with a game plan so you can help the patient.
Unfortunately, in today's healthcare system where time is of the essence, frequently care is fragmented. The nice thing here is we can walk down the hall or get on the telephone and share our thoughts in both directions and come up with an integrated, comprehensive plan.
I'm Jacob Thatcher from Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm a firefighter out there. As a firefighter, we put on about anywhere from 50 to 70 pounds of gear, and then sometimes we train and we do obstacle courses and we put on masks. At certain points, I felt like I wanted to take my mask off because I felt like I couldn't breathe or I couldn't catch my breath, almost like drowning. As the father and a husband, you want to be able to provide for your family, but if you don't even know what's causing all these issues, I mean, it makes stresses at home, it makes stresses at the job, and stress everywhere.
Jordan stopped smiling at about 3 months when the eczema started becoming exacerbated on his body. A few months later, it just started, his cheeks were getting, you know, they looked like they were slapped. And then that redness just did not go away. And then it just began to like permeate all over his face. And we've had people stop us on the street. We've had people stop us in the supermarket. And I think that their intentions were well-meaning to say what was wrong. But the way it came out was like, what's wrong with him? What does he have? Oh my God, did you see his face? You're talking about a little baby, and that broke my heart all the time. We couldn't go anywhere. But nothing was working. And I felt like the worst mother in the world.
Well, Jacob has significant shortness of breath that's limited his ability to do activity and has placed him on restricted duty with his fire department.
Come on, push! Come on, push! You got it! Come on!
We had to figure out why his action level is falling, particularly with exercise, why he's feeling so tired and fatigued.
You know, you walk to the ends of the earth for your kid. So what was a trip to Colorado? So we called National Jewish and he got in as a patient. And I just kept saying, God, let this be it. Because I don't know what else we can do. We don't have any backup plan after this.
There are several things they're noticing here that they did not find back home. So I think it speaks volumes to they have the procedures and they know what they're doing here.
He is not an easy case, but we never say never. The abnormalities are there. It's limiting this gentleman, and it's keeping him from performing his livelihood. So we will go to every measure possible using some of our more sophisticated testing that we are fortunate to have that allow us to probe in more depth. It's a fascinating detective journey.
Well, I think that's our place. That's why the patients come to us, why we look at them and not stop where someone else would stop.
Today we'll do both upper lobes, right upper and left upper. At the end of the case, we'll basically be done with your all three bronchoscopies. When she was referred to me, she was told that there's nothing else that can be done for her. Our message to her was, no, we will continue fighting with her and figure out a way to help her. And that's exactly what we're trying to do.
National Jewish is life-saving.
Within 1 week at National Jewish, Drew and his skin began to heal.
I remember one time they unwrapped him, and then we were screaming, and we were so happy, and Jordan was looking at us like we were crazy. But we were so happy, and that to me, I was like, it works. This is the right place. This is going to happen.
They saved his life. Honestly, the National Jewish Health saved his life. He's enjoying his life. We're enjoying life with him. This didn't happen overnight, and this didn't happen just anywhere. It took a special team of doctors who really cared. So National Jewish Health, you saved his life, and forever grateful for that. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts.